Let's look at the operating income in more detail. The income statement starts at the top with revenues. Revenues can also be called sales or turnover. It represents the income that a company receives for selling goods or services. Below revenues, we have direct operating expenses, such as purchasing inventory. This line is often called cost of goods sold or cost of sales. This is the first expense line on the income statement. After deducting cost of goods sold from revenue, we arrive at our first subtotal on the income statement, referred to as gross profit. Gross profit is equal to revenue minus cost of goods sold. If we take the gross profit and divide it by the revenue, we calculate the gross profit margin. Next on the income statement come the indirect operating costs. These include things like research and development, administration, selling, and distribution. Several of these line items may be grouped into one, sometimes called selling, general, and administrative expenses, SG&A, or just general and administrative costs, G&A. If we take revenues and deduct the direct operating costs and then deduct the indirect operating costs, we arrive at the next subtotal, operating income. The terms profit or earnings can be used interchangeably with income. Operating income is often referred to as EBIT, which stands for EBIT, earnings before interest and taxes.